Hi, it's your coach and colleague, Dr. Brenda Bowers with Vessels of Honor Church and A Word for You, Inc., where I am the co-founder along with Apostle Bill Bowers of Vessels of Honor Church, and I am the founder, the president, and the CEO of A Word for You, Inc. I am asking you to please like our pages, share them, and subscribe and follow us on Facebook, on Twitter, on YouTube. We aim to make sure that our world is a better place because at A Word for You, if we change our words, I believe that we can change our world just by making choices by the second. And at Vessels of Honor, we are committed Christian ministry to make sure that we are equipping God's people to live a holy life while we are on this earth awaiting his return. Guess what? I told you to just hang in here. It was Palm Sunday, but I told you next Sunday was coming. It was Monday, and I told you that Sunday was coming. It was Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, and every day I told you Sunday was coming. Well, guess what? It's here. It's Easter 2021, and it is day 8. Because we often forget that Resurrection Sunday started a new beginning. It wasn't on day 7, but on the day of completion when Jesus finished all of that work on Saturday. But rather, today is day 8, and we are here to experience the Resurrection Sunday because he is risen. Thank you for being with us again as we have been so honored and humbled to share this Passion Week with you that has culminated into today. It's Sunday and he is risen. What happened on Sunday? The tomb is found empty, for Jesus has risen. Jesus appears to the Marys and to his disciples. You have the scripture references here. Please go and read these scripture references because they are so powerful, they are so exciting, and they are so empowering. Be educated through the word of God. That's where we can find our instruction, get our knowledge, our understanding, and ultimately our wisdom. It is Sunday, my friends, and he is risen just like he said he would. So we just look at a couple of these scriptures because it is more than we can get to you in these couple of minutes that I'm trying to keep these down to, just as snippets for you to be able to grasp, as nuggets you're able to chew on. It's Sunday and he is risen. The tomb is found empty, for Jesus has risen. And when we look at this particular verse in Matthew 28 and those first 10 verses, it is such a phenomenal word of God. Now, after the Sabbath, toward the dawn of the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to see the tomb. And behold, there was a great earthquake, for an angel of the Lord descended from heaven and came and rolled back the stone and sat on it. This is what happened in the heavens when the heavens come down to the earth. His appearance, this angel, was like lightning and his clothing white as snow. And for fear of him, the guards trembled and they became like dead men. Those guards that were supposed to make sure that body went nowhere. But the angel said to the women, "Don't be afraid, for I know that you seek Jesus who was crucified. He's not here. He has risen, as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell the disciples that he has risen from the dead. And behold, he is going to come before you in Galilee. And there you're going to actually see him. See, I have told you." So they departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy. And they ran telling his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them on the way. And he said, "Greetings." And they came up and took hold of his feet and they worshiped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Don't be afraid. Go and tell my brothers." He called them brothers to go to Galilee. "And there they will see me." And he said to them, "Don't be alarmed. You see Jesus of Nazareth who was crucified. Well, he is risen. He is not here. See the place where you laid him." And our last slide for this Passion Week has the word of God here, because there's so many profound things. And I was saying, where can we end this? Where can we end this as we now begin to journey towards the ascension? We have to have the ascension because it wasn't over at the resurrection. He continued to walk on earth and do great things before he went to the right hand of his Father and before the Spirit of God descended so that he could dwell within us. So you have to stay tuned because the story's not over, even though it's Sunday. So I decided to end in John, the 20th chapter, where Jesus appeared to his disciples. And there are so many things that happen in the book of John and the way that he wrote. It is, I think, befitting for us to close out our Passion Week study with this scripture, John 20, 11 through 30. But Mary stood weeping outside the tomb, and as she wept, she stood to look into the tomb, and she saw two angels in white sitting where the body of Jesus had lain, one at the head and one at the feet. They said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping?" And she said to them, "They have taken away my Lord, and I do not know where they have laid him." Having said this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing, but she did not know it was Jesus. Jesus said to her, "Woman, why are you weeping? Whom are you seeking?" Supposing him to be the gardener, she said to him, "Sir, if you have carried him away, just tell me where you've laid him, and I will take him away." Jesus said to her, "Mary." And when Mary heard that voice, she turned to him and she said in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher. Jesus said to her, "Do not cling to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father, but go to my brothers and say to them," call them brothers again here in John, "I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and to your God." Mary Magdalene went and announced to the disciples, "I have seen the Lord," and that he had said these things to her. Now, on the evening of that day, the first day of the week, which is Sunday, day 8, new beginnings, the doors being locked where the disciples were for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and showed them his side. Then the disciples were glad when they saw their Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, even so am I sending you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, and this is why I chose this passage to end our Passion Week highlight with you. He breathed on them after the resurrection, before the ascension, before the descending of the Holy Ghost. And he said, "Receive the Holy Spirit. And if you forgive the sins of any, they are forgiven them. If you withhold forgiveness from any, it is withheld from them." The power that Jesus gave them when he saw them without any retribution of how they had treated him prior to him being crucified. Now, Thomas, one of the 12, called the twin Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples told Thomas, "We've seen the Lord." But he said unto them, "Unless I see in his hands and mark of his nails, and unless I place my fingers into the mark of the nails and place my hand into his side, I will never believe." And look at this, from a new beginnings, from Thomas making that statement, as we are closing this Passion Week highlight session. I hope these days have been as exciting to you as they have been for me to deliver. 8 days later, his disciples were inside again, and Thomas this time was with them. And although the doors were locked, Jesus came and stood among them and said again, "Peace be with you." If there is a takeaway today, that is certainly part of my tagline, "I speak peace unto you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here, see my hand, and put your hand and place it in my side. Do not disbelieve, believe." Thomas answered him and said, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you believed because you've seen me? Because blessed are those who have not seen and yet believe." And Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples, which are not even written in this book. But these are written so that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that by believing, you may have life in his name. Such a pleasure to be with you. Such exciting times. In 2021, he is risen, just like he said. Stay tuned, stay connected. Click like, subscribe, and share, and follow us on all of our platforms. Until soon, this is your coach, colleague, and friend, Dr. Brenda Bowers. Love and peace.